What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. So as you guys know, crazy update, crazy news. The iPhone 5S, iPhone 6, iPhone 6 Plus as well got another version of iOS. iOS 12.4.4 came out yesterday, and I didn't talk about it in the iOS 13 videos. I was doing those, but don't think I left you guys hanging. And this update actually did something really weird to my 5S, which I'll talk about in a second. But this update really wasn't too big. It was about 53.6 megabytes coming from iOS 12.4.3, so not a humongous update at all, very small, and really it fixed only one thing that I know that I can hear of that Apple fixed. I don't really know if they fixed anything else, but within FaceTime there was an issue of some people were having. It was like a security bug at the end of the day, and Apple went ahead and patched it. I'm not really too sure what the bug consisted of, and I'm not too sure what the bug did to your phone or FaceTime, but apparently that is fixed now, so that is really cool, so we don't really have to worry about that. There might be other little fixes here and there, but as far as I know, that is all Apple fixed. It was just a bug fix update, no, features or anything like that added at all. So if you're trying to update to think you're going to get like iOS 13 features or something, that's not going to happen. But before I even go further, dude, it's just crazy that this phone is still being supported. This phone came out in 2013, the iPhone 6 came out in 2014. Like, it's just a crazy thing that Apple is still doing. And if they can even get one more update up until 2020, dude, that would be insane. To say this phone was supported from 2013 to 2020 is literally crazy. And I think this is what Apple is going to start doing. They're going to kind of, with that iPhone 6S and SE, they might end it at iOS 13, but they're still going to give those security updates to those phones. So like, it's still going to get iOS 13.5.4 or something by the time we're over there. So even though iOS 14 is still out, this phone is still going to be getting iOS updates as well, including the iPhone 6S potentially. I don't know that there's a huge possibility of that, but it might get like 4 or 5 actual full iOS versions, then like 1 year of security updates or something. So that'd be pretty crazy. Also, I think these are the longest lasting consecutive updated phones from Apple. I know like the 4S and 5, those things had those updates as well, but that was like after like a 3 or 4 year gap. I wouldn't really consider it that consecutive. This one is more consecutive than that one. But I did run a benchmark though, and this is pretty crazy. On August 26th, which is the last time I ran a benchmark on this phone, I had a multi-core score of 66,202, and I just re-ran it. And it actually did go up to 84,168, which is pretty crazy because that is higher than the score I got on my iPhone 6. And I was kind of running through my iPhone 5S, and I'm like, dude, this phone is actually still pretty decently fast. Of course, loading speeds and everything will still be pretty slow, I would imagine. But it's not a bad performing, I take that back, it's not the best, but we're not really talking about that. We're talking about the software updates, and dude, I'm so happy this thing got the next version of iOS in terms of iOS 12. So that's pretty much it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit that like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it would mean so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel, all those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.